आज तीर्थंकर महावीर यूनिवर्सिटी के डेंटल कॉलेज एंड रिसर्च सेंटर में एंटी रैकिंग वर्कशॉप का आयोजन किया गया, जिसमें रैकिंग को रोकने पर चर्चा की गई।
In our time, there were pros also, but now we have just cons, if I am not wrong, Dr. Chandra. Right? So, not taking much time, let us see what Dr. Chandra has to enlighten us with anti-ragging. It is a serious offense now, ragging, so we must listen to it very, very carefully.
To, you know, sensitize against ragging, and this is, the responsibility is given by Dental Council of India. So first of all, I mean, it's my pleasure, a great privilege that I am here to address and interact with valued professionals, or I must say the gem of the profession. Dr. Tango is there, Dr. Manish Goyal is around, and other faculties, plenty. And you cannot compete at the global level once you are not digitalized. Now things are fast, so fast that everything is digitalized as far as my field is concerned, and Dr. Goyal must be seconded to that. Even the impression taking and making cars will be, you know, everything will be passed now. You need to have just a scanner, scan it, you send it to the lab and your appliance is ready and you can deliver it to the patient. Even in prosthodontics, I mean, things are changing so fast. So these things are important that you should have a global capabilities. And third is what I feel, the social responsibility as a dental surgeon. Because once you go there and we come to, you know, smaller places, you go there and practice. So our responsibility is there for the society, those who are poor, patients, those who cannot afford even orthodontic treatment or a costlier treatment. So all the more is our responsibility that we should provide that things, the good treatment which goes to the ground level. Even in the villages, because I have gone through all these phases from a village to this place, so it was entirely a hard work and determination. So what I feel that the social responsibility we should definitely have into consideration. And one should always for an opportunity. As soon as you get an opportunity anywhere in the world, you should cash out. And what Dental Council of India is working, the research aspect will also working on that. Because we are lagging in this, the Dental Council of India makes sure that every college should have a research department separately. So these are the things that we should come at the par and compete with the world. Because we are, I think, one of the largest producing dental surgeons in the world. So we have a power. जैसे हमारे प्रधानमंत्री साहब कहते थे कि मेरे पास इतनी यंग जनरेशन है, द यंगर पीपल इज सो मच दैट इफ वी कम आउट सो वी कैन डेफिनेटली रूल द वर्ल्ड वेदर द डेंटिस्ट्री इज कंसर्न और एनी फील्ड इन दिस. सो बिफोर आई मीन आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू प्रोटेक्ट माई स्पीच, अदरवाइज आई कीप ऑन यू नो गोइंग ऑन दैट. सो आई कम बैक टू एंटी रैगिंग मेजर्स. तो एज आई टोल्ड यू, this responsibility is given by Dental Council of India to all the members that we should go all the dental schools in India in that definition. And those who are from the northeast, sometimes, you know, the student teases them, you know, cheeky pinky that way. So they came to me, in fact, whether it comes under the definition of a ragging. So I said yes. So the Dental Council of India, when they realized it, that this is not covered everything. So now we have a new definition. This definition has been now sent it to the ministry. First of all, you know, you should be very clear about it. Ki what are the rules and regulations we follow it in the council, for that matter, any teaching institution or even the ministries. So what the rules we have in India, first is a constitution, right? Constitution is then, 1940 is sudden when we will be independent and the constitution came. Dr. Ambedkar have drafted the constitution, so you know all that. Everybody has to follow the constitution, and constitution is in a lifeline of our country. Right? So we follow that constitution. That second thing comes is an act. And fourth thing comes as a regulation. And the fifth thing is come as a executive order. And the next is comes as a policy decision. So how the act is formed? Suppose we have to make an act on writing. So first of all, we'll ask for all over India, those who are eminent people in that field, do you draft certain things which can, you know, we can implement as a regulation of the writing. So when that draft is came to us, we put up in a executive meeting of the Central Council of India, the general body, then it goes to the ministry, and then ministry send it to the parliament. Actually, Central Council of India, there is any case is reported in the Teerthanker Mahaveer. Because for being at that place, the Muradabad in this area is close to my heart. Because I have treated cases from, the, you know, starting from 89. So there was no orthodontist, whether the entire Kumayu area is concerned, or Kashipur, or Meerut, Mujaffarnagar. All these, till, you know, the Uttarakhand was not there. So I was an orthodontic advisor to almost all the schools in Dehradun and Mussoorie. Whether it's a Pune school or a Venom school. So, you know, I was treating the elite class, and I was treating with the very small people, and the prisoner testing in a very, very small place. So it was a journey which, you know, I have traveled it from a very small place.